In life and auditioning, it's funny how it's always the simple little things that can throw us off our game.
Can I help you?
Yes. I'd like your earliest time.
Okay. That's not very specific.
Like the bitchy audition monitor. Their funky attitude has the ability to upset your entire demeanor before you even enter the room. It's sabotage.
Okay, I have 11:50.
11:50 is cool.
Oh, it's cool. Really?
Really?
Debit card?
1 second.
I don't have all day.
And it's a shame that we give these little things the power to affect us, because most of the time, it's not that serious.
There you go. Thank you. And who's in the room?
Look at the sheet.
The kicker is that life has a tendency to turn simple little things into complicated big things.
Okay, you're in the way. Hello?
Okay, I'm going to need a later time. Much, much later.
It's the simplicity phenomenon. The simplicity phenomenon. Take, for instance, a simple little lunch date, accentuated by a simple little bowl of soup, and a simply beautiful guy you've been dating for a little over a week now.
One bowl of chicken noodle soup for you, monsieur.
Thank you so much.
What time do you go into the gym?
I have my first client at 3. You came into the city early just to see me.
Well, mostly for the free soup.
And you share a simple laugh and a little kiss, and you're just simply enjoying the little moments you're sharing together.
Are you okay?
Yeah, it's just my back.
Then something not so simple enters the picture and foils it all.
Old Coors Line injury.
You were at a Coors Line on Broadway?
No, Detroit Community College. I'll be right back.
So, in case one, we see how life can go from zero to complicated in 0.25 seconds. The simplicity phenomenon, case two. So, sometimes we make little changes to prevent simple things from turning into complicated things, like the time of day we work out. Then, in 0.25 seconds...
Watch it this time.
Sorry.
Often, our little problems just refuse to go away.
You don't have to be sorry, Pa.
Yeah. Sorry.
No matter how hard we wish they would.
So why did you ever call? Long time no see workout, buddy.
No. I mean, busy. Really busy.
Now, as we just learned from case two, when you try to hide from your little problems, they tend to find you in a big way.
Oh my God, are you okay?
I'm fine.
Hey, you hiding from me or something?
Don't flatter yourself.
Why would he be hiding from you?
Excuse me? Do I know you?
I'm Trevor, Preston's boyfriend.
Boyfriend?
I guess you finally found the one.
Well, it is what it is.
I think I should go.
Don't.
And you are?
Just a friend of Preston's. I just dropped in to say hi. I guess I'll holler at you some other time.
And sometimes we try to deny that those simple little things could really be great big things.
Was he your old boyfriend?
No, just... it was nothing.
I guess I should probably get going pretty soon too, but you'll call me tonight, right?
Of course.
Baby?
I don't even want to talk about it.
First of all, why were they both here? That sloppy. Second off,
you and Trevor are boyfriends now?
We are so not boyfriends.
So he just assumed a relationship.
How do you assume a relationship?
Rude for that.
Preston! Mike, today is not the day.
Oh God. What happened here?
Girl, it was a clash of the lovers. It got real hood real quick.
Shut up. Okay, I'm really surprised you have a job right now.
So I have a problem. Guess who's playing for my audition today?
Obviously Donovan.
So I took the 515 slot, the last one. Should I go?
Why wouldn't you go? You're both in the same business, and you're both going to be in the same circles. Like Tristan, unfortunately.
Well, we haven't spoken since the last time.
Listen, business is business. You're going to walk in there like the strong girl that you are, and let them know what's up.
Okay,
my turn. So, this fine man at the park asked me to be his workout buddy.
So what's the problem?
He's straight.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever. He's not that straight. Any man that asks a girl like you to be his workout partner must be questioning a few things.
What is that supposed to mean?
I'm just keeping it real, homegirl.
You're rude.
The simplicity phenomenon, case 3. Here we find that, quite often, we just need to assess things for what they actually are. A simple audition, a little bruised ego, they're nothing more than things that just happen.
Hello, I'll be seeing.
The tricky thing is that sometimes we're not ready to accept things as they are. Sometimes we can't comprehend how simple it really is, or we just don't want to.
Davis Roberts speaking. Yes, I'm available to come in. Yeah, my email address, yeah, it's
You have a visitor on the phone.
Really?
Hey! I got done early, I thought I'd swing by and pick you up.
Sometimes accepting simple little things as they are makes you long for the complicated, great, big things you wish you had.
Jeremiah! You never return any of my phone calls.
Well, I've been busy.
And no one in the world is that busy.
Well, I guess I just didn't want to talk.
You are one difficult bitch, do you know that?
I really have to be going.
I miss you. I miss the hell out of you. I miss laughing with you. I miss your voice. I miss your face. God, this whole thing is so stupid. I was stupid. You were stupid. This fight is stupid. Me walking out in this hallway right now and embarrassing myself is stupid, but it's okay. How long are you gonna make me keep talking? Jeremiah, I am sorry.
And maybe, just maybe, the simplicity phenomenon teaches us that everything is just simple and little.
That's all you have to say.
Because no matter how catastrophic the occurrence may be, all we can do is live through it. All we can do is share a simple little laugh, or a simple little hug, or shed a simple little tear and live. All we can do is live. It's so simple.